Hey, I'm Hans and welcome to Tech Edge. Connected devices at the edge present a major challenge for IT decision makers in the age of Industry 4.0. So how can you manage thousands of OT network endpoints without significant investment in software development time? Well, today we're going to talk about connected devices at the edge and talk through real-world applications of AWS IoT Greengrass. The cost of developing an in-house IoT device management solution can be astronomical. Many companies believe that the development cost just cannot be justified. So consider this. Instead of spending hundreds of thousands or even maybe millions of dollars developing and maintaining your own device management platform, why not invest in an existing one? Amazon Web Services, abbreviated to AWS, offers a suite of services for edge applications, designed to streamline your time to market. Using OnLogic and AWS IoT Greengrass can help you effectively manage your endpoints in a scalable way. So, what is AWS IoT Greengrass? I'm going to be saying it a lot. It's an Amazon Web Services product designed to bring the power of the AWS cloud to edge devices. AWS IoT Greengrass allows edge devices to respond to local events in real time and leverage AWS cloud-connected services natively on the edge device, even when the device isn't connected to the internet. It does all of that while operating securely with AWS end-to-end encryption. Using local hardware like OnLogic's line of AWS IoT Greengrass qualified PCs brings the power of the cloud to connected devices at the edge. AWS IoT Greengrass works by using a locally deployed core software, in our case pre-imaged on an OnLogic AWS qualified PC. The OnLogic PC then acts as a local data aggregator for your connected devices, sensors, or local connectors. The Greengrass core communicates to local devices in their native protocols, such as OPC UA, LoRa, or Zigbee, using the AWS IoT connectors. When the PC is connected to the internet, data can then be sent to the cloud via MQTT, which is a lightweight messaging protocol designed for the IoT. From there, you can easily feed your data into AWS services like Amazon S3, EC2, or SageMaker, depending on your application needs. All right, let's walk through an example. Let's say you're a supervisor for a system of streets in a major city. You want to improve traffic flow using data management. To reach your project goal, you plan to deploy a series of computers with AWS IoT Greengrass to interact with the connected devices at the edge, including local sensors, traffic lights, and other devices out in the field. First, let's talk about the intersection of two streets. By deploying a computer with AWS IoT Greengrass, you can use local cameras to detect the number of cars waiting at an intersection. Leveraging machine learning via the IoT Greengrass software, you're able to instruct traffic lights to act in real time based on that data. The result? You can reduce congestion and improve the driver's experience by eliminating unnecessarily long red lights. You can also send data back to the AWS cloud to further train your machine learning model and improve device functionality for future traffic scenarios at that intersection. By using Greengrass to process application data locally on the edge computer, you're also able to transmit leaner edge process data to the cloud instead of raw data stream. This saves you money on transmission costs while also allowing you to run the system offline if you need. So even with an intermittent internet connection, you can still have all your systems running. Looking to further analyze your data with the full power of cloud computing to identify trends, find efficiencies, and improve the flow of traffic in your city? Well, use AWS IoT Analytics to process, organize, and route data while making it available to other AWS services for use in applications like AWS QuickSight for data analytics. I hope this overview of AWS Greengrass and how it complements edge computing was helpful. Of course, if you have questions, leave them in the comments below. And if you liked the video, give it a thumbs up and be sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on Tech Edge.